take a look. Looks good.
Who is now enrolled in that great spirit army whose marching causes no sound. But in our memories, their souls and voices go marching on. Proudly, we remember their service to our country. Because of them, our lives are free. Because of them, our nation lives. Because of them, our country is blessed. May the ceremonies of the day deepen our reverence for our departed veteran. Let us not enshroud his memory in thoughts of sorrow. Tears or words of sympathy cannot bring back the comfort of those loving hands or the music of voices stilled. Only the solemn pride in his service in those who live to remember. We realize how futile or mere words to express our deep and abiding sympathy in your loss. May you feel that he is at rest and in endless peace. God bless our departed veteran and his spouse. The chaplain will offer prayer.
Let's pray. Father, we entrusted you, our brother Gerald and sister Mary, to your mercy. You love them greatly in this life. Now that they are freed from its cares, give them happiness and peace forever. Our beloved veteran has passed. Welcome him and her into paradise, where there is no more sorrows, no more weeping or pain, but only peace and joy forever and ever. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let your perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
The honor guard will fire a volley of three, followed by taps and folding of the flag. The report can be loud. If you have sensitive hearing, you may want to cover your ears. Air Force Post.
Fort Hunt. Ready, aim, fire.
Saluted it, and then he stood at ease. I looked at him in uniform, so young, so tall, so proud, with hair cut square and eyes alert, he'd stand out in any crowd. I thought how many men like him had fallen through the years, how many died on foreign soil, how many mothers killed? How many planes, pilots' planes shot down? How many died on foreign soil? Died at sea? How many foxholes the soldiers' graves. Oh, freedom is not free. I heard the sound of taps one night when everything was still. I listened to a bugle play, felt the soldiers' chills. I wondered just how many times the taps had meant amen when the flag had draped the coffin of a brother or a friend. I thought about all the children of the mothers and the wives, the fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, of unmarked graves at Arlington. No, freedom is not free.
On behalf of the President of the United States, the United States Air Force, and a grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your loved one's honorable and faithful service.
This is an envelope staff has put together. It's got a map and information as to where the casket will be interred here at the cemetery, the rules of the cemetery, what you're going to do, can't bring hours, additional information. And I have a short poem here entitled I'm Free. I'll adjust it a little bit. Don't grieve for us, for now we're free. We're following the path God laid for us. We took his hand when we heard his call. We turned our backs and left it all. Perhaps our time seems all too brief. Don't lengthen it now with undue grief. Lift up your hearts and share with us. God wanted us now. He set us free.
On behalf of the Department of Veterans Affairs and a grateful nation, it's my honor to present the Presidential Memorial Certificate. This is in honor of Gerald's service to our country. And this is an application that you can use to apply for additional copies of the certificate if anyone else in your family would like one as well. Thank you so much. I'll set it under here. I'm so sorry for your loss.
This concludes the military portion of the service. We are honored to be of service to you. Thank you for allowing us to pay our respects to our departed comrade. At this time, the Air Force will remove the casket for placement. Thank you again.
Honor Guard.